Memorable.
Inspirational.
Powerful.
Life-changing and inspirational.
That morality cannot be legislated, but behavior can be regulated. It may be true that the law cannot change the heart, but it can restrain the heartless.
Dr. King has influenced me personally by making me feel braver and more confident to stand up to injustice, because if he hadn't done what he did 50 years ago, the world would be a completely different place.
You know, being an African American and being able to stand here in the, I don't know, the shadow of his legacy is really, it's just amazing.
This is someone who actually like sacrificed his life, like he committed his entire life to this sort of thing. And because he was thinking of not just himself, but was thinking of so many generations that were coming to come after him.
I'm definitely reaping the benefits of his struggle and standing in his legacy. I'm also a product of what he fought for.
And it gives me this sense of purpose and this sense of continuing the footsteps of what he's done.
There is a problem of racism, the problem of poverty, and the problem of war.
When I listened to Dr. King's speech, one thing that he said that really stood out to me was that people of all races, all ethnicities need to work together to fight against racism. And it's not just up to the victims of racism to try and eradicate it. We'll never get rid of it unless we all work together to fight back against racism.
The speech itself was life-changing, phenomenal. In particular, the sense that you can't change people's hearts but you can change the law was something that I've taken with me for the whole of my life.
The line about, I can't make them love me, but I can stop them from lynching me.
He said, out of the mountain of righteousness, we will hew the stone of justice.
The law can't make a man love me, but it can restrain him from lynching me. And I think that is pretty important also.
When we met him in the room over a cup of tea, he was just seemed like an ordinary guy. You know, you ask him a question and he'd answer it quite calmly. So you didn't get the feeling of any self-importance. He just seemed like an ordinary man.
I think the university is in a unique position because we were the only British university to offer him an honorary degree. And we can help, through that link, promote the causes that essentially he died for.
I think it was incredibly important for the university at the time, and actually in today's world as well. I think when we look back at the visit, I think it's a timely reminder to our students, particularly here, of the work that Dr. King did, and looking forward his legacy, actually how far have we come in 50 years? I think that's a really important question that we have to ask ourselves as young people, as at the end of the day we're going to be shaping the society that we want in the future.
I feel like I'm part of that sort of history. I feel like Dr. King thought this place was special, this place thought that he was special, and I think it shows that this university really values that sort of civil rights fight. The university values standing up for what you believe in. And I think it makes me feel more confident to stand up for what I believe in if I see injustice, whether on campus or just out in the world.
At the same time, I always had this urge to always stand up for what was right. And it was like observing people like Martin Luther King that made me see that there are people who have actually done that. In every generation, there must be people who are always stand for what is right and always stand for what they believe in. And I think that's one of the greatest ways which has influenced me to always stand up for what I know is the right thing and to always stand up for truth.